So a quantum computer, it's a fundamentally new type of computer that could help us solve certain types of problems significantly faster. There are problems that could take billions of years to solve on our classical computers, that is our normal computers, like your laptop or your phone. But on a quantum computer, you could just solve these problems in just seconds. A normal computer works by bits. So I like to use this donut to illustrate a bit. You can imagine that the bit one is equivalent to this frosted side of the donut, and the bit zero is equivalent to this plain side of the donut. Well, in quantum computers, instead of using classical bits, we use quantum bits. So a quantum bit, it can be one, and it can be zero, but it can also be something called a superposition of zero and one. And I like to think of it like a spinning donut. Right now, if I ask you, is it zero, one, you'd say, well, it's sort of both. It's a combination of zero and one. And then this superposition allows you to solve some problems faster on the quantum computer. A quantum computer could impact a lot of industries, including the financial industry, including medicine, materials, logistics, space. The possibilities are quite endless. There's actually multiple ways to build a quantum computer. There isn't one way to do it. And that means that there's actually multiple ways that it can look like. So for example, one way to build a quantum computer is by using diamonds. Another way to build a quantum computer is using photons, which is basically light. Another way to build a quantum computer is by using something called trapped ions. So it's basically atoms with a net electric charge, and they confine it in a particular space, and they can manipulate that. Another way to build a quantum computer is by using superconductors. And this is actually one of the most popular ways to build a quantum computer. For example, Google and IBM are working on this. And if you've ever seen a picture of it, you'll see that there is a quantum chip. It's very small, but around it is this whole infrastructure. In fact, it looks like a chandelier. And all of this infrastructure is in order to cool down the quantum chip, but also to control and manipulate the quantum chip. One of the reasons why quantum computing became popular is because a quantum algorithm was found that could basically break a lot of the encryption methods that are used on the internet. So this is actually what keeps your credit card information secure, your bank information secure on the internet. But a quantum computer, if it were powerful enough, if we could build one that's powerful enough, it could actually break that. And that is a big concern for people, including governments. So one reason why people should care is we should actually start thinking about new ways to encrypt our data on the internet that could be safe against quantum computers. So in artificial intelligence, it's actually been around for quite some time, and people had come up with algorithms to actually do AI or machine learning. But the problem is we didn't have computers that were powerful enough to actually run these algorithms. And so it's only recently that, you know, basically AI has really taken off because we have really powerful computers right now. And so I would say with quantum computing, we're sort of, we're at that stage where we don't really have a powerful enough quantum computer to actually run all of the quantum algorithms we want to yet. And so we're waiting for the hardware itself to get more powerful so that we can get to that point.